Hey there, today I will teach you how to go through airport security. The TSA made changes that will start the middle of June 2020. I'm going to show you step by step how to get through the new airport security screening. You will learn what to put in that gray bin so that you will not have to get out of line. These updates to airport security are for you travelers who have not flown in a long time, or if you learn better by seeing a visual. I'm going to set up my hope chest as a TSA security line conveyor belt and show you exactly what to do. I will show you what to pull out of the gray bin based on the newest updates of the Transportation Security Administration X-ray screening procedures. The TSA wants to prevent cross-contamination because of all the coronavirus information out there. Now the TSA may send you out of the line to repack your food, your accessories, and your liquids. If you just need to learn what the three changes are, I will list a video in the iCards and you can click on that and watch it in a new window at any time. A video travel tips based on my experience as a pilot's wife to help you travel the globe without a worry in the world. Click subscribe and the happy little bell if you like this video. One of this summer's TSA changes is that you are in charge of placing the barcode on the document reader machine by the podium where you show your identification to the officer. Remember that this change is to protect the TSA frontline officers from cross-contamination of any of the coronavirus. Your barcode is going to be on your electronic ticket or your paper ticket. 24 hours prior to your flight, you can check in online, or you can wait and check in with a person at the ticketing counter. You will need a confirmation number to check in, and usually you receive that when you purchase your ticket. Then you will be able to print or pull up on your phone your boarding pass or your ticket. When you get through the TSA line and are in front of the podium with the TSA officer, you will have to still hand your identification to the officer. That's what I did in Houston and in Atlanta when I had to go last week. Your identification can be a passport or it can be your driver's license. In some airports, they may not want you to hand the identification to the officer. You might just have to pull it up, just watch what other people are doing. So you hand that identification to the officer and you are the one putting your barcode on the barcode reading machine. And then you lift it up, they might have to see the barcode or something like that. And then both of those documents go in the closest pocket that you can find. And then later when you are at the gate or if you are through security and you're at a bench outside of security, that's when you put them in their secure locations, whether it be your ID back in your wallet or in a certain pouch that you use. If you do have TSA PreCheck, you do not have to pull out any of these things. So you can stop watching the video. The video that I made the other day did not take, so this is the second try. As I show you these steps, I'm gonna switch back to the video that explains the rule and the changes for each item. After you've put your ID and your phone away, you are walking up now to the little conveyor belt X-ray screening. The first step is to take out any electronic that is larger than a phone and put it in its own gray bin and send that on down the line. You might think you have to put your belt or your wallet inside the gray bin, but no more. There's a new rule. You are leaving your phone, your ID, or your wallet in a little pocket until you get through the end of security. All accessories like your belt, your phone, your wallet, heavy jewelry, or a heavy watch that might make the alarm go off, those are all gonna stay in your personal item bag now or your carry-on suitcase. If you forget to put those items in your personal bag or your suitcase, you may be ejected and have to go repack them and then get back at the end of the line. Remember, the TSA wants to prevent cross-contamination, so they do not want to touch any item. And people have asked me about earrings and your wedding bands. Those can stay on. If your earrings are a heavy metal, I just always don't even put them on until I get through the security line. Besides your electronics, the only other things you might take out would be your bag of food, and I'll tell you about the new rules for that. For the X-ray screening process of food, it used to always stay in your personal item bag or your suitcase, and you are always allowed any type of food. You can take produce as long as you're staying in your own country. You can also take like packaged food or a leftover bag of cereal. All of that goes in your clear bag. And all food that is in your suitcase or your personal item bag needs to be in this clear bag. It does have to be clear. and then that goes in the gray bin. If it does not, you may be ejected and have to repack it correctly and get back in the line. When I go through regular security, I take off my shoes and I put them in the same bin as my food because my food is protected by the bag, so they're not going to touch. The shoes aren't touching my food. You're also going to take out your liquids bag if it fits and a 12 ounce hand sanitizer bottle. Now, I will tell you about the liquids changes now. For liquids, you took care of that before you got to the conveyor belt. Any liquids that are aerosol, gels, liquids, any food like cooked oatmeal that can smush and squish is considered a liquid. Even though it's technically food, it's first and foremost a liquid. Its container has to be in a 3.4 or 100 milliliter container or less. And all of those liquid containers need to fit in a quart-sized, clear-ish bag. The TSA says that we are now allowed a big tub of antibacterial wipes as well as that 12 ounce hand sanitizer container. And so that would be also pulled out and put in the gray bin in addition to your liquids bag. It does not count as a liquid that has to fit in the liquid bag, but they do ask that you pull it out. And then just to be safe, if you are bringing a huge tub of antibacterial wipes, it has a little bit of liquid in the bottom, so I would just put that in the gray bin as well. But if you take it from my travel hacks, put 5 or 6 antibacterial wipes in a bunch of different plastic bags and put those in different places of your suitcase and your personal item bag so that you save space. So now you're back to the beginning. You have your liquids bag, your hand sanitizer, your food bag, your shoes, your electronics that are bigger than a phone. You have put them all in their bins and you just put them all through and you're ready to go. One travel tip is to make sure that all of your items have begun on that conveyor belt across the little bumpy lines to be screened before you walk through the X-ray screening area. Now that you know what to put in your gray bin as you walk through the TSA security line process, think like an expert. What things can be done at home? You can leave all those accessories, even your belt, in that suitcase at home before you even leave for the airport. You can pack your food correctly in the clear bag at home and then have it in your personal item bag. You can also pack your liquids, your 12 ounce hand sanitizer, your tub of antibacterial wipes if you're gonna take those out, and put those, have those all easily accessible at home inside that personal item bag. And then when you get to the airport, you can be as cool as a cucumber. But if it's a cucumber, make sure it's in that food bag, remember? Anyway, thanks for visiting, and don't forget to click that little bell if you like this video.